Hello, it's Silje, and now I'm going to talk about the 10th prompt of the 12 Days of LitMas, and that's my favorite non-fiction author. And I do like to read non-fiction now and then, but I tend to go by subject and not by author. I like to read books about books, and books about science and biology, and also memoirs, but I did find an author. I've only read one book by him so far, but I really like his style, and it's quite unique, I think. So I know that I will read more of his books, and that I will enjoy them, because he's a really great writer. And that's Havboka by Morten Strøksnes, and this is a Norwegian book, but it has been released in English. The title can be translated to the Book of the Sea, but that wasn't what happened when it was translated. It's translated to Shark Drunk. And when I first heard the title, I was quite taken aback because I hadn't expected that. It was quite something else from the Norwegian title, but at the same time, it does make sense. It's about the great Greenland shark. And you can't really eat the meat of the shark because it's toxic. So if you do, you get really intoxicated and you will be feeling drunk. And therefore you are shark drunk. So it's pretty clever, I have to admit. And this is a personal documentary, but it is so much more. It's about Morten and his friend Hugo, and they're going out to the ocean in the north of Norway to catch the big Greenland shark. And this has been a big dream for them for many years, and this book is about them trying to do so. But it's also a book about their friendship. It's a book about the north, about nature, about the ocean, and the people who are living near the ocean up in north. And most of all, it's about the ocean itself. It's about all the myths that are surrounding the ocean. And it's like the Norse myths and the Greek myths and like all the myths in the world. And they're packed into this in such a brilliant way. It's about the history of the ocean, about the ocean travelers, the fishermen, the people that are living near the sea. It's about biology. You learn a lot about all the creatures and all the organisms that are living in the sea. And it's about the environment, the importance of the sea to the planet. And yeah, it's about so much. This was all consuming to me. And I thought it was wonderful when I read it. It's so filled with anecdotes and musings, and they're like these big passages that are just like reading poetry. It's an ode to both the north of Norway, but mainly it's an ode to the sea. And I was so captivated by it. This is Morten Strøksnes' latest book. It was released in 2015. But this is also his 9th book, so he has a pretty huge backlist. And he is known for his documentaries, and especially his traveling or his travel documentaries. And he tends to go to places that are pretty remote, and he meets people and visiting places. He's been to the mountains in Mexico, and also been driving around in the east of Europe. And he also written a book about this investigation. He went to Congo, where 2 Norwegian men were imprisoned due to a murder. And so he has a quite wide range of subjects, I think. It's always pretty personal, have I heard. I have only read this. But it's usually very personal. He is a part of the stories he's telling, and it's about him meeting these people and discovering these places, but at the same time, he's also telling the stories of the places and the stories of the people. I was thinking about the quote by Nabokov that I shared with you earlier today about the writer being a storyteller, a teacher, and an enchanter. And I think Morten Strøksnes is all of those things. He is an amazing storyteller. He teaches you things, and he kept me enchanted throughout this book. And I'm pretty sure that he will enchant me with his other books as well. So that's why I picked Morten Strøksnes as my favorite nonfiction author. And I think if you're interested in the sea or in myths or life, I think you should try Shark Trek because it's just fantastic. So yeah, that was all from me. Who is your favorite nonfiction author? I am curious to know. And yeah, I hope you're having a wonderful day and that you are relaxed and ready for the holidays. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I see you later. Ha det!